Hello everyone, welcome to the semicolon. This tutorial is a part of the series Data Analytics with Python, and today we're going to learn about dimensionality reduction. In a previous video about data preprocessing, I had mentioned about dimensionality reduction using PCA and SVD, that is principal component analysis and singular value decomposition. In this video, we're going to go ahead and implement them using scikit-learn and check the loss in accuracy due to reductions in dimensions. So dimensionality reduction also helps us in visualizing data, as it is tough for us humans to process data about 2 or maximum 3 dimensions. So let's get started. I'll go ahead and import all the necessary libraries, the main ones being PCA and truncated SVD from scikit-learn decomposition. And for the data, let's import Boston housing dataset, which has around 18 columns, and try to reduce its dimension. So let's put all the feature columns in df underscore x and the target columns in df underscore y. Df.describe gives little description of each column. Now let's blindly put this data on linear regression by splitting randomly into test and train and check the accuracy so that we have our benchmark set. The accuracy turns out to be somewhere around 72%. So it is 72% with all the information present. Now this is a poor model, but we do not care because we are trying to observe the effect of dimensionality reduction by PCA and SVD on this model. So now let's declare PCA and reduce our data of 18 features to 10 features. Not a huge thing, but let's try it anyway. And we follow the same old procedure of splitting test and train and fitting it into the data. And as far as the accuracy is concerned, after reducing it to 10 dimensions, the score turns out to be around 69%. So, which is not a great reduction, just by 2 or 3%, and we've got half of our data removed. So this is okay, this is good, but and if we lower the number of dimensions, the score goes further down. The score becomes unbearable as we move down. So this model could roughly reduce the number of features by half. Let's try doing the same thing with singular value decomposition. The number of components we try out first is 6 to compare it with the scores of PCA. And it turns out to be around 61%, which is around 2% less for SVD when compared to PCA. So PCA for 6 features had around 63%. So here, and for the Boston dataset, we were successfully able to reduce the data into half by sacrificing 2 to 5% of accuracy. And if we went further down, our accuracy dropped even more. But if you see the covariance matrix of this data set, you can see the fields are not related by a large margin to each other. And that is why dimensionality reduction here doesn't make a lot of sense. The dimensionality reduction in PCA tries to exploit the relation or the covariance between the features and try to make features independent of each other. That is, when plotted, you'll see a 90 degree between each feature. So it tries to make the features orthogonal, but this is not the case here. So let's load some data where we can appreciate the true power of dimensionality reduction, or the PCA to be specific. The MNIST handwritten dataset has around 800 columns, and most of them are redundant. There are a lot of zeros, and this should be a good dataset to reduce the dimension. So the random forest classifier, let's benchmark it on it. So the random forest classifier gives an accuracy of around 96%, which is quite good. But do we need all 800 columns? Because that is a huge number to train. it is okay with linear regression or random forest, but as we move to deep neural networks, it is a pain, 800 columns. So let's reduce the number of features to 10 and repeat the same thing. Because the curse of dimensionality makes training very inefficient in some training algorithms, and hence it is very good to reduce the dimensionality. In fact, it's very efficient. So with 10 features, we get around 90% of accuracy. So the loss in accuracy is around 6% when the dimensionality is reduced by 80 times, which is huge. And 80 times less features and just 6% of accuracy loss. It is huge. But let's try to improve the accuracy and get little more closer. So let's repeat the experiment with 20 features and 25 features, and let's repeat the same thing again, and the accuracy turns out to be around 94%, which is very little difference from the actual, from all 800 features. So we could reduce the features by 40 times by just sacrificing 2% of the accuracy. Now PCA.explained variance gives the variance of each feature, each new feature, in decreasing order. And the value is kind of representation of the amount of information contained in each new feature. So whenever the variance starts to get little low, you can start ignoring the number of columns from there. So one more application of dimensionality reduction can be in visualizing data. So let's try to visualize the classification in this very data set from the digit 0 to all other digits. So just for the purpose of visualization and simplification, we are just trying to classify it into two, 1, 0 and other all digits. So we can reduce for the purpose of visualization, we'll have to reduce all 800 features into just two features, because it is easier for us to visualize only two features. If we increase it, then it's again tough for us to visualize. So let's visualize with two features. Before visualizing, let's check out the accuracy. So the accuracy turns out to be around 40%, which is very poor. And there may be lot of overlaps in visualization, but anyway, let's go ahead and plot each point. So the red point will represent the digit 0 and the green point will represent everything else. We'll plot only 5000 points so that it's not a pain on my computer. And this plot shows a nice separation of digit 0 with other digits. There's an overlap, and that is because reduction in dimensionality by such a huge factor. But you can understand that dimensionality reduction can help us visualize the data as well. So there's one important point to note though. If the data isn't separable in lower dimensions, it can be separated by going into higher dimensions. And that is the whole concept on which support vector machines are based on. So it's not like this is not separable. We can separate it in higher dimensions. So that's it for this tutorial. We could visualize the data and we could reduce the data by sacrificing very little accuracy using principal component analysis. And same can be done with SVD. So that's it for this tutorial. If this helped you in any way, hit the like button. And if you want to watch more of these, hit the subscribe button as well. Thank you.